One of the most famous myths in the Greek mythology is that of Sisyphus, the mortal who was condemned by the gods to a never-ending torture. He would roll a large boulder up a hill, and every time he would reach the peak, the boulder would roll back down, forcing him to start all over again. But what was it that made the gods so angry? What was it that made them punish him in such a cruel way for all eternity? This is exactly what we are going to see today. Our story begins with Sisyphus, the king of Ephyra, a city that we all know today as Corinth. Sisyphus was a very smart man and a cunning person. As a proof of his resourcefulness, there's the story of him besting Aftolikos, who was probably the most notorious thief of ancient Greece. Aftolikos, you see, stole some animals from Sisyphus, and normally he would have gotten away. But Sisyphus came up with a very smart plan and was able to prove that Aftolikos was indeed the one that stole his cattle. This is something not to be underestimated, since Aftolikos was a thief with godly powers. He was able, for example, to change the appearance of the things that he stole. This way, people had no real way to prove that he actually stole something from them. If you want to know more about this, I'm planning to create a separate video. The moment it is ready, it will appear as a small notification in this video. Do check the description as well, because I will also put a link there. But let's get back to our original story. In case you haven't noticed, Greek mythology is full of stories with the infidelities of Zeus. Of course, this one is no exception. This time, the beautiful woman who sparked the interest of the king of the gods was Aegina, the daughter of river god Asopos. So one beautiful day, Zeus saw Aegina and thought it would be a good idea to seduce her. Seduce is a polite way to say kidnap her, but let's try and not be too melodramatic here. So as I was saying, Zeus kidnapped her, seduced her, and took her to a small island in the Aegean Sea so that no one could find him. His whole scheme probably would have succeeded, but unfortunately for him, he completely forgot about Sisyphus. You see, Sisyphus understood the importance of information, and he knew that knowing things gave him leverage, especially when it meant knowing things about the gods. So every day he would wake up and climb up a small hill in his town so that he could see if there was anything interesting going on. And I think we will all agree that seeing the king of the gods kidnapping a beautiful woman qualifies as interesting. After a while, however, the father of Aegina started getting worried. His daughter had gone missing for quite some time and she was nowhere to be found. So when he learned that there was a smart person by the name Sisyphus that knows things, he decided to pay him a visit and ask him if he knew anything about his daughter. Sisyphus was willing to tell him the truth, for the right price, of course. So after a bit of negotiating, the river god made him an offer. If Sisyphus could tell him where his daughter was, then he would create a spring from which fresh water would come out and water all the barren fields in his town. Sisyphus really liked the offer and decided to tell him the truth. This did not sit well with the king of the gods, and as a punishment for giving him in, he asked Ares, the god of war, to send death to capture Sisyphus and take him to the underworld. The smart Sisyphus, however, was not willing to go down without a fight. So when death came, he thought of a plan to trick him. He asked Death to show him how the chains he used to capture the souls of the dead worked, and before he knew it, Sisyphus used the chains to capture him instead. So from now on, Death was a prisoner in the palace of Sisyphus, which meant he was not able to perform his normal duties, that is, accompany the souls of the dead to the underworld. This infuriated the gods of Olympus, since people who died could not move on. And as you can imagine, there was chaos everywhere. The one who was most annoyed, however, was Ares, who despite winning his battles, his opponents would not die. So now Ares had to intervene and free Death, and after freeing him, he captured Sisyphus and surrendered him to Death so that he could take him to the underworld. Sisyphus yet again had still not said his final word, and came up with a plan to deceive death. He asked to speak to his wife one last time before he was taken to the underworld, and asked her to not bury his body the way she was supposed to. So when Sisyphus went to the underworld, he presented himself in front of Persephone, the wife of Hades, and asked permission to go again to the world of the living in order to make his wife give him a proper burial. He also made the argument that the gods themselves would profit, since a proper burial meant that there would be offerings for them as well. Persephone agreed, but little did she know that Sisyphus had no intention of returning, thus tricking death and prolonging his life among the living yet again. This time, however, the gods had just about enough of Sisyphus' machinations, and sent Hermes, the messenger of the gods, to take him back to the underworld. And because of all the people he had tricked and the disrespect that he had shown towards the gods, the judges of the underworld came up with a rather cruel punishment. They would have him roll a large boulder up a hill, and every time he would reach the peak, the boulder would roll back down, forcing him to start all over again, and that for all eternity. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please subscribe and leave a like. Until the next time, see you around.